Give me a blanket, super. Nice crack.
Hello again, folks. Welcome to another edition of Between the Banks. A Bob Goosh. And look at that gorgeous sunrise. Alright. First fish in the boat. And it is a nice speckled trout. Nice speck. Stick with us. We're speckled trout fishing. I'm going to show you just where they're at, who, what, where, when, why, and how. Stay tuned. Number one goes in the box. Stick with us. Be right back after these messages.
Hello.
It's another Rock'em Sock'em edition of Between the Banks. Between the Banks is brought to you by Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Louisiana.
This is our love. This is our life. This is our home, Louisiana. This is our day.
Take the short drive to Lafourche Parish, where both history and adventure await. Explore the historic Laurel Valley Plantation, the E.D. White Historic Site, and Bayou Lafourche Folklife and Heritage Museum. Discover the Acadian culture at the Wetlands Acadian Culture Center. Treat yourself to an exciting fishing trip or relax on a guided swamp tour. And sample true Cajun cuisine at one of the many unique restaurants. Call or log on to visitlafourche.com.
Folks, everybody gets Between the Banks. Here's how easy it is. Go to your address bar, type in betweenthebanks.com, search, and here you are. The latest videos, services, and products provided by Between the Banks. Check it out, betweenthebanks.com. Everybody gets Between the Banks.
Another nice one.
I'm going to reach and grab the net. Oh, yeah. Nothing but big ones. So, we took off this morning from Boudreaux's Waterfront Motel. Jumped into West Canal, came out to Little Lake, and started heading southwest, on the southwest course to the islands. But when I got to the rocks, there's pogies jumping, fish popping all over the surface. I mean, it's really on here. Bait, I got bait, moving water, and clean water. Three things I need to catch these babies. So I stopped here, nobody's here, and these are here. Nobody but the specs and Captain Bob. Stay tuned. More details coming. Show you just how I'm rigged up. Stick with me.
He's heading to the rocks. Oh, another nice speck.
Another nice one. In the net goes. Really nice one. Really nice fish. Alright. So, pulled up at the spot. Through top water, got here early. I mean, I was here before the sun came up. Through top water, didn't do anything. Started catching them on Carolina rig. I'm gonna put this one in the box. I'm gonna show you how I'm rigging. All right. So this is our new Daiwa gear from Tides. This is a 7-foot medium action Team Daiwa rod. And I'm on a Revos. I use the Legalis and the Revos reels. And I use the 300H series. I've got 12-pound test Spectra by Berkley. It's a low-vis line, but it's also a thin diameter line, diameter of 10, but the strength of 12. At line's end, I have black crane swivel tied to the 12-pound test. I've got a clip-on weight here. It's got to be 1/8 ounce or less. That's what we're using here. Clipped onto a triple fish leader, 20-pound test. Look how short that leader is. Through the lips of a cockahoe. Now everybody's been saying, man, Bob, bait chopped. We can't get any bait. Not true. All you have to do is right across, as you're coming down to Leeville, right across from the seafood shed, you're gonna see Blessed Trinity, T-Rand. I usually call him ahead of time to make sure he's got him. And I pick them up there, and I got no problem getting cockahoes from him. And you know that's what I love to fish with, cockahoes. Now, Tides, tackle store. All of his tackle he's got on sale. So you need to check him out. Not only is he competitively priced, but when he throws these clearance sales, he's got this after Labor Day clearance, and that's when we're shooting this show. Is Labor Day weekend after everybody left. We started fishing the Tuesday after Labor Day. So that's what we're doing. He's got food, croissants, breakfast burritos, biscuits, po' boys, all of that over at Tide's, and all of my tackle comes from Tide. Now, for those of you that are saying, yeah, Bob, you're sponsored, blah, blah, you get all kind of brand new gear, and it's expensive. Believe it or not, this rig that I'm fishing with sells for around $160. If you go in Tides and you say, Bob Goo sent me, and I want a rod and reel like Bob uses, they'll sell it to you for $150, and they'll spool it with the same line that I'm using. So go check out Tides. Really good deal. All right, so I'm casting that line out. I'm keeping my rod tip up, okay? And all I'm doing is I'm pulling it through the grass. When I think I got a fish, I'm feeling him. If I get snagged in the grass, if it's not a fish, all I do is that and it comes free, not getting hooked up here. So there's how I'm rigged. Go check out the gang at Tides and tell them Captain Bob sent you. This one hit the corn. Cast it right over by the rocks. Let's see what I got here. Oh, foul hook banana fish. Now for all of y'all that are asking, man, Captain Bob, what the heck is that fish that looks like a baby tarpon? Okay, a lot of people call them banana fish. Some people call them lady fish. But great bait for a bull redfish, but not a good eating fish. And there's plenty of them around. So what I did was I switched over to a cork. I got my Carolina rig out in the back, but let me show you this. This is just a regular Carolina rig that I use. Same setup as that Carolina rig, except I have a longer leader. And then I slide the weight down and clip on a weighted rattling cord. And I clip it right underneath the swivel. I don't go on the 12-pound test. This won't crimp this line to the point where it'll break. This will always hold up. With all the weight up at the top, the minnow just swims free, all under the cork, all over the place, tracks fish. And if I know there's fish there and I'm catching them one after another on the cork, I'll slide the weight down to slow the minnow down. So that's how I'm rigged on this. Same 7-foot Daiwa from Tides. Got a Legalis reel on this one. but real good rod for a cork line. And it really throws out Country Mile. I mean, really works well. When you get it out there, you're just gonna pop it lightly. Not a shotgun cork. I very seldom use shotgun corks because they spook big fish. I just want a little noise, a little, and those two BBs in the cork are there. And I don't have to pop my line hard. I can just shake it like that, and something will come up usually and hit. All right, so there's my other rig that I'm using to catch these specs. Stay tuned. I think I got a stingray. Oh no, it's a flounder. Flounder. Oh yeah. Treat. A treat. There you go, just spit the bait. Nice one. Now it's a small one, so I'm going to release it. But flounder season is awesome. Now on specs, you can have 25, got to be 12 inches or better. Flounder, you can have 10 per person, and there's no size limit on flounder. And they've made a big comeback. So I'm going to let him go to get a little bit bigger. You can always tell when a flounder is biting on the line because it's mushy. It's almost like a stingray bite where you feel a bump, sits on it, and then starts swimming off and set the hook. It's usually a flounder. All right, rock's still producing fish. It's slowed down. Our incoming tide that we had early this morning has stopped and it's fixing to switch back out. But I know I can catch fish here on low tide also. So stay tuned. I'll give you more details on the spot when we get to the map feature. Stick with me. Feels like a stingray. Whenever you're fighting a stingray and he gets down there and he sucks on the bottom, just take your line and ping it. And that'll usually bring him up. Oh, catfish. Boy, he was digging like a stingray. All right. So like I was telling you, we're at the slow time. Our high tide is over. Tide's beginning to switch. I got a northeast wind blowing, so it ought to be ideal here. So I'm hanging. All the other boats are running around. I know the fish aren't on. By the way, folks, we got Leeville Speckled Trout and Redfish Rodeo. First weekend of October. Awesome. Awesome. It's just a great rodeo. Make sure you get your tickets. Griffin's is the headquarters in Leeville. I've got tickets. All the folks in Leeville got them. So just give us a holler and we'll hook you up. We'll definitely be there and we will film the winners like we usually do. So I'm going to take this cat off and see what else we can get on. Slow time. All the undesirables are biting. I don't know if this is a bull red or a gaff top, but he was taking drag. I must investigate. Like I say, when the tide slacks and you're in between bites, this is what happens. I don't know. Feels like a huge gaff top. Come on, be a 9-pound spec. 9-pound spec. Negative, Ghost Rider. It's a monster card head. Holy mackerel. Well, I'll tell you what, folks. Only one thing to do. Let's go take a look at the marina minute. All the fine people that make fishing Lafourche Parish great. Tourism Commission right there, Highway 90, LA 1. Stop in there, they'll put you on all the places to go. And then of course all the people in Leeville that do a great job of making life comfortable. Boudreaux's Waterfront Motel. Tie your boat to the bed. Music on Saturday nights. Entertaining the guests. Cowboy Jim always cooking something up. Great place to stay. Right across the street, Griffin's. There you go. Get your ice, you can get your unleaded ethanol-free fuel right there. It's convenient both on the dock and 24 hour on the road. And they've got a great grill too. Check out their croissants, great biscuits in the morning, omelets. I mean, it's just great. Plus fried chicken, a host of things right there. It's where I get my grilled chicken breast sandwich. Then, of course, all the other businesses in Leeville. Seafood restaurant, really good eating. The bait shops, you gotta check the schedule, because a lot of times the bait shops don't have bait or they're not open. Now that we're on the fall, winter times has come, they're on that schedule. And then renovations. Can't stop talking about renovations. Pathfinder boats, now they got War Eagle aluminum boats. You ought to go check them out. Yamaha, take care of anything that happens on your boat. Maybe Coda, power pole, whatever. Renovations can handle it. So let's go check out the Marina Minute and I'm gonna follow it with the map. Stay tuned. All right, gotta take this yonk yonk off. Hopefully that bite's gonna happen before y'all have to leave. Stick with us.
Boudreaux's Waterfront Motel. Dock your boat at the end of the pier right under your room. Set up your grill. Got your own fish cleaning station. Your own ramp. And for big groups, enjoy the sunset at the Boudreaux House. Boudreaux's in Leeville.
Griffin's Marina and Ice has bag, block, and blown ice for whatever size boat. Both dockside and roadside ethanol-free fuel, convenience store, breakfast, crispy chicken, all conveniently located in downtown Leeville.
Renovations is your complete marine center. Minn Kota, Motor Guide, Power Pole, Sales and Service, Trailer Parts, Bilge Pumps, their friendly, helpful staff will keep you on the water. Hardware, marine, and home decor are at Renovations.
See on the depth finder, look at the big fish swimming by. I'm in 3.1 feet. We had that little cool weather, so it lowered the water temp to 69.3, but it's on its way up. We're early morning here. So I'm on the plateau. I got rocks, look at that bottom. I got all of that, look at the fish swimming by, and I'm in shallow water here. The trench is gonna be 7.4 feet of water, but I don't wanna anchor in the trench. I wanna work the edges and catch all the fish that are cruising, swimming by, plus the ones that are sitting in the trench. So let's go over to map and I'll show you right where we're at. Pages, map, let's go full map, enter. Okay, so you can see how often I come here. I'm coming out of the Southwest Canal right here, coming into Little Lake, taking a southwest course. There's the Red Camp. Right here where I'm at in Deep Bayou is the rocks, and there's the helipad. Here's Grand Bayou Blue. All of this is loaded with big specks right now. So I'm working right here, especially if I can't run out to open water. See my trails to Castet, Philo Bryce, and all that? You can see I'm sitting right here at the rocks. Now I'll zoom in a little bit more for you. Notice, this used to be just a big pass, Deep Bayou, just to be a pass. Had grass and all right here. You can see the pipeline running north. You can see how much erosion has taken place here. So all of this is gone. The rocks have become the major irregular feature at this spot. Position, north, 29, 13, 287, west, 90, 17, 020. I'm anchored right where I can throw into the trenches. Now the pipeline is really visible. See where I'm at here? See my position to where I can cast into that trench? There you go. And there's the old pipeline passing through. All right. Specs are beginning to turn on. Got a nice one. Not a nice one. See how patience pays when you get to the fishing spot? If you see all the boats running around, you know the fish aren't biting. The bite hasn't happened. And it's important that you check that out. You can do it on computer. I use a little handheld GPS, fish and hunt program. Tells me when the fish are gonna bite. and also great for hunting too. So check that out. Now I think I got another fish on the Carolina rig. You know me, I'm a greedy fisherman. I can't fish with just one line up. This may have been a shark. Oh, let's see what it is. Oh, I believe it's another speck. Oh, nope, it's a hardhead. So, we're not all the way into speckled trout biting one after another. Still catching the undesirables too. But once the tide gets ripping and it's moving already, life is gonna be good in this neighborhood. I guarantee it. Stay tuned. I don't know what this is, but it's nice. Could be a big gaff, could be a big cat, could be a speck. You can see there's a speck coming in on that other line. Got my brother-in-law out here fishing with me. He's got a trout. See what this is. Come on up. Oh, it's a big old stingray. Alright. Stay tuned. The good fish and the bad fish. It's the good, bad, and ugly at the fishing spot. But at least we're catching some specks. This one's not a cat. This one feels like a trout up on the surface. Right in time. You just gotta be patient, folks. And if you know, yep, sure is. Sure is. Oh, it's swinging. If you know when the bites are and you know what's happening at the fishing spot, things can turn out great. It's 10:30 and the bite, the early morning bite, we caught those earlier trout, took a break. 10:30, tide has switched. Look at the spot right here. You can see how that water's running around the rocks. Look at the nervous water I got coming through there. So that's what makes the spot. Once you get that tide moving and you get the nervous water, you're gonna catch fish. Got slicks all over the place. I mean, no reason to leave. A fishing spot goes through a cycle. Look, we got birds diving, everything's turning on. A fishing spot goes through a cycle. You get there early in the morning during this time of year, September. You get there early in the morning, fish are on, then they'll stop. Then you wait till that tide switches, they're gonna turn on again. Well, folks, there you have it, another edition of Between the Banks. Don't forget, a lot of things going on. Leeville Speckled Trout Redfish Rodeo, first weekend in October. Great prizes, two-day tournament, family fishing. August, and then we're gonna be cooking again. I mean, it's in my opinion, one of the best rodeos to fish, and it's fun. I mean, it's really a fun rodeo. Griffins puts it on. Everybody in the parish gets involved. Don't forget, you're coming into the fall season now. September, late September, October, November, and depending on when the winter comes, the fish will really turn on. So if you want to come fishing, give us a call and book out your fall fishing trip. Fall season out of Leeville is awesome because you don't have to go far and you can catch fish. I hope you enjoyed this edition of Between the Banks. It's a shame that y'all have to leave, but we're going to stay. Stick with us. You'll see what happens at this spot maybe next week. In the meantime, good luck fishing.